Welcome to Hindu Analysis, September 6, 2018. So today we are going to see all these articles. So the first article is the US State and Defense Secretaries arrive in New Delhi for 2+2 dialogue. So what the news here is, today the US State and Defense Secretaries with our country's counterparts is going to have this 2+2 dialogue. So we all knew that during the Obama administration, the US declared India as a major defense partner in 2016. And during Trump administration, we got the status of Strategic Trade Authorization 1. So these two indicates that how much India is important to US in terms of economy as well as in terms of trade, everything. So in this 2+2 dialogue, what the discussion is going to be likely to happen is majorly on CAMCASA agreement. So what this CAMCASA means, communication and coordination on security issues, which means we are going to sign an agreement on communication and coordination on the security. So between India and USA. So if India and US sign this CAMCASA agreement, then what is going to happen in the future is the security gadgets, which means the high level security gadgets and high level security equipments from the US. So we are going to procure that security gadgets and we are going to place it in our defense equipment, and we can make use of those equipment to make our military even more modernized. So in order to make our military more modernized, we are going to procure these kind of security gadgets from the USA. For that, we have to sign these kind of agreements. There are three agreements. One is LEMOA, LEMOA, and BECA, and this CAMCASA. So these three are defense pacts or foundational defense pacts between India and USA. So now in this 2+2 dialogue, they are going to sign this CAMCASA alone. So this LEMOA is already got signed, and this BECA is going to be get signed in the future. So now they are going to sign this. And for example, in we are having army, navy and military, right? So in terms of army, the security gadgets we are going to install is going to provide even more secure voice and data links to our army. And in terms of Air Force, we are going to make use of the precision GPS gear, which we are going to procure from the US. Similarly, we are going to get Sea Guardian drones from the US for Navy purposes. So these are some of the examples for the security gadgets or the equipments which we going to get from US for modernization of our military. Similarly, we are going to have high-tech military equipments sale. That means we are going to have these kind of military items from US. So now we are going to see what this CAMCASA agreement means. As we already saw, this CAMCASA is a communication compatibility and security agreement between US and India. So it is majorly for the development of our armed forces, and to obtain, it is majorly aiming at obtaining of the military hardware from the USA by means of three defense pacts. As we have seen before, this is LEMOA, CAMCASA and BECA. So our Indian military is going to function on high-end secured and encrypted communication equipment, which is installed on American platforms, which means America is going to provide the platform and we are going to install our equipments there and we are going to make use of that. So for example, these are things: C-130J, P-81 aircraft, Apache and Chinook helicopters. These are the examples that we are going to make use of those US high level equipments in our military equipments. So in this pic, you can see that is the agenda of the 2+2 dialogue. That means what is going to likely to happen during the 2+2 dialogue. So the first one, what they are suggesting is US likely to push India on how to operationalize the India's status as a major defense partner. That means we are now major defense partner to US. So how we have to make use of that? That is what US is going to say in this 2+2 dialogue. This is likely to happen. This is what they're expecting. And the second one is defense purchases. They are discussing about the defense purchases, and US is likely to push India for this CAMCASA agreement, as well as it is urging India to reduce the oil supply from Iran, as well as reduce the imports from the Russia in terms of the missile systems as well as the defense equipment. And so now we are going to see what are the concerns. That means India and US is going to sign this CAMCASA agreement. So by signing this agreement, what could be the concerns in the future? If we see, the first major concern is India's critical security communication is now handling over to US, which means US is providing the platform and we are making use of that platform. This raises security concerns in terms of our military communication. And the second one is jeopardize India's established military ties with Russia. That means if we are moving towards US, it means our military ties with Russia is now getting deteriorated. So this is also a second major concern. Third major concern is the indigenous Indian military platforms may face compatibility issues with this CAMCASA. So during this 2+2 dialogue, both India and US may express its concerns over each other. So the US concerns are mainly two. One is the zero out energy supply from Iran, which means we, India, are the major importers of the oil from Iran. But US is now putting this CATSA, right, which means countering adversaries of America through Sanctions Act, which means it is putting sanctions on Iran, North Korea, as well as the Russia. So whatever the countries which is going to deal with these three countries, it is also coming under the ambit of the CATSA. So this forces India to reduce the oil supply from Iran. It is a first major concern in terms of US with respect to India. The second major concern is India is going to procure S-400 Triumph missile defense system, which worth $6 billion. So it is also again a major concern to US. So these two are the US concerns. So now in terms of with respect to India, what is the concern towards US is we, for ensuring the regional stability, we need the support of US in bringing the name of Hafiz Syed under the terrorist list. So it is also, again, we need the help of US in order to include this name into the terrorist list, as well as to reduce the terrorist activities in the region. So the next one is the trade talks stuck as US presses oil and aircraft sales to India. So what the news here is, we already have $2.5 billion of trade in terms of oil and gas with US. So but now US is wanting India to be committed even more. So we have to additionally import more goods from the US. So why? Because if you see in this picture, India already has a trade surplus of $23 billion with America. But now US is trying to wipe out that surplus by forcing more imports by India. So they force us to even more import from US in order to eradicate that, or in order to reduce the trade surplus. So trade surplus means we are exporting more than what we are importing. So now we are exporting more to US. So US is now trying to export same amount to India. So that is what the content here. So a draft agreement in US last month committed additional imports by India, where means in terms of civilian aircraft as well as in the natural gas. So what is the major concern for India here is the steel and the aluminium tariff, which is levied by the US, as well as now US is reviewing our GSP status, which means generalized system of preferences status, what we are submitted to US. So what is this GSP means? Generalized system of preference, which is a duty-free access. So which allows preferential treatment to certain number of specified goods from beneficiary countries. So if India is a beneficiary country to US, and now we are going to export some XYZ products to US, so now we have to pay a very little amount of tax in order to export those products, or we need not pay tax at all. So this is what this GSP status stands for. So now we submitted a list of certain goods and how the tariff should be, etc., to the US, and US is now reviewing it. So this is also a major concern, whether they accept it or not. All things are under the concern. And the one more important thing is India is now trying to put retaliatory tariff. They are putting tariff on steel and aluminium. So now we are going to put some retaliatory tariff over the US products. So it is also going to likely to happen from September 18 onwards. So the next article is dangers of storing the food grains in the open space. So most of the food grains, whatever cultivated in India, it is procured by the government from the farmers, and it is stored by the Food Corporation of India in godowns, or as well as the spaces which is allocated for that. But those spaces are not closed spaces, they are open spaces. And due to that, nearly 30.52 million tons of rice, wheat, maize, etc. is getting wasted, as well as 10% of harvested grains are getting lost. So these, not only these are the main concerns, also it is getting damp. That means the grains are getting wet and fungus ridden. So if it is getting fungus ridden, then it is not for the human consumption, right? So it is a major concern in terms of health perspective also. So this method of storing openly is called cover and plinth method. That is, they are going to put all those things in an open space, and they are going to cover it with the tarpaulins. So this is called the cover and plinth method. So if you see in this picture, this is how they store the food grains. So by means of consuming this moldy grains or foods, what is the major concern here means? The World Health Organization states that the mycotoxins, which is usually found in this moldy grains and foods, so it is associated with the human disease because it produces a chemical called aflatoxins, which is a major cancer causing agent. So we are now going to consume this moldy grinds or foods either in direct form or in a flour or flour based products form. So we are getting it from the market, we are making into a flour and we are making use in our home. So it is obviously going to affect the human conditions or human health conditions. And exposure of this higher concentration aflatoxins food, it causes abdominal pain, vomiting, hepatitis, as well as even sometimes death. Similarly, lower dose exposure of this aflatoxin food, it leads to impaired growth in the children. So it affects from the children till the adults, all are going to get affected by means of this aflatoxins. So this is a major concern by means of storing the food in the open space. So if you see in this picture, it is called a silos. So every other country in the world are making use of this type of containers in order to store the food, which keeps the food very dry as well as airspace. So we are also have to follow the same method in order to protect our food and even to promote the health conditions of our people. So what is the way forward here is the abundance of steel. We are having abundance of steel, cement, as well as other building materials and the technology of know-how. So we have to make use of that effectively in order to store our food in a proper manner. So the next article is Integrated Military Theater Commands. So the Kargil Review Committee and the Naresh Chandra Committee, these two committees submitted a report which proposes the restructuring in the higher defense organization, which means to integrate the three armed forces in order to make the synergy between the army, navy, as well as the air force. So not only the synergy between these three armed forces, but also among the different tools of statecrafts like bureaucracy, military, research, development, intelligence, internal security mechanisms, etc. So in order to make all these things to work in tandem, they proposed the restructuring and the integration of the armed forces. But what the news here is, the Indian Air Force officers, they rejected this proposal, stating that there is already very limited sources or resources available with the Air Force. So if you integrate this, it is going to put more restrictions on the Air Force functionalities. So that is what they state. And also they stated that it is unnecessary at this point of time. Why? Because capturing the ground beyond a, if any war occurs or if any disturbances occurs in any region, then capturing the ground beyond a few kilometers by the army, mobilizing the army, it takes a lot of time. Similarly, taking the physical control of vast maritime space by the navy, so it is also taking a lot of time. But the air force, in terms of air force, means it is very fast and efficient. As of now, we should not integrate all these three forces and we should make them work independently. This is what the air force officers stated. So the air force officer also stated that if you are going to integrate all these three armed forces, then it would seriously hamper the application of the air force itself, because already we are following to do more with less. Air force having very less resources, but they are doing even more what we are actually expecting. So air force is a better alternative because it is first going into the war field and it is shaping the battlefields to our advantage even before the army and the navy enter into the combat. So we have to make use of the air force as much as possible by means of providing the independency to it, not integration. This is what the air force officer stated. So this slide talks about how we make use of our armed forces during the war times. So the first one is the Kargil, second one is the Indian Parliament attack, third one is the Mumbai attack. So during all these three attacks, the air force is not that much efficiently used. So that is what the major concern here is. So during the Kargil, the Pakistan army occupy our territory on the LOC line, and very smaller fraction of our Indian army is going was getting deployed in that LOC, and even the air force was restricted at the bombing post. So it is not even making use of the air force. So this is a first concern. The second one is during the Indian Parliament attack. So similarly, during the Indian Parliament attack, during the Operation Parakram, it took 48 days to mobilize our army soldiers to the location. So but if we make use of the air force, then it will be very faster, right? So this is also a major concern. The third one is the Mumbai attack. This time also the use of force was ruled out because they thought like not attacking Pakistan could gain us more than attacking Pakistan. They even ruled out the use of the force. So this is also, these all indicates that we are not efficiently make use of the military forces. So in all these cases, why India did not immediately attack Pakistan? So that is what the question which is rises in everyone's mind. And also another thing is the dominance of America's military power, even though it is there, the political objective of America in Afghanistan is not yet achieved. So it indicates that there is always a conflict between the political objective and the military part. Okay. So what they are telling in this slide is we'll not able to predict the future. That means we do not able to predict how the character of the future wars will be, because the structure and the nature and the character of the wars is changing. It is not like before. So for example, if Pakistan is going to attack our Punjab province by means of armies, so whether it will be a conflict between the two armies of India and Pakistan, or it will affect all the local population, everyone. So it is also a major question. Similarly, in terms of China, if China is going to attack our Himalayan watershed and by means of using modern technology, information warfare and ballistic missile capability. So these are all indicating that the nature of the war is now changing. So how we are going to retreat, or how we are going to retaliate these kind of attacks? So this is also a major concern. So what is the way forward here is, instead of extolling its own importance towards each other, all the three armed forces should sit together and have to find the realistic answers for the changing character of the war. For example, are the three strike corps in Pakistan that is explicitly telling or showcasing our combat potential. So taking this as an inspiration, we have to much more improve our armed forces capabilities. So the last article is Supreme Court's bat for minor rape survivors, which means the NALSA's compensation scheme for women victims and the survivors of the Sexual Assault Other Crimes 2018 Act. According to this, the women victims and the survivors of the sexual assault is getting compensation amount. Similarly, now it is extended to the minor children also under the POCSO Act. Okay, so the minor survivors of rape or sexual assault will now get the compensation in par with the women victims. So this is what the Supreme Court recently ordered. And for what kind of victims means the loss of life, gang rape survivors, unnatural sexual assault and miscarriage as a result of assault, or loss of fertility and victims of acid detox. These all people could get the compensation under this POCSO Act. So this is now extended to the minor children. That is what the news is. Thank you.